for Christmas!
Come home for Christmas!
Come home for Christmas!
This has been awesome! I'll never be the same!
Best weekend ever, Paul and Chrissy, we drove from Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. We just love Matthew and his family and their ministry in Pop Week.
Love it.
Show them your face.
Thank you so much for hosting. Thank you all. Sharing your family and your town with us.
I absolutely loved everything about the weekend. I really don't want to go home, and I don't want this to end. And I am looking forward to doing it next year.
And just to be here for this weekend is incredible. We're blessed to be here. We thank you, Matthew.
Yes, thank you. From the bottom of my heart.
I could tell right away, though, when I started meeting people, like this was going to be a special weekend. Not because of everything we had planned. Hopefully that was part of it, but it was really because of the heart and the kindness and the excitement that everybody from around the country brought to Franklin.
For
it was
sure.
Just amazing. They were thanking me for the weekend before we even started, which was really sweet. So the weekend started with a VIP event. It was a chance for me to share some of my new record that had not yet been released. So they got to hear songs that nobody's heard except for you, really. Mm-hmm. And then we surprised them and they were all part of a music video shoot for a song called You Changed My Name. Friday was the official kickoff, and it kicked off with a huge event downtown Franklin, Tennessee, where I am the four-time host of the Franklin Christmas Tree Lighting in Franklin. So cool. Thousands of people in the square. We sang Christmas carols and had a children's choir. But then, just down the road, we had Christmas cookies and hot cocoa, mm-hmm. and we did introductions, and I sang some songs. Lulu sang with me. We even had a couple get engaged.
Yes.
On the very first night.
Yep.
I mean, it's kind of pretty amazing to kick off an event that way. So that was Friday night, the kickoff. On Saturday morning, for Come Home for Christmas, I dressed as Sir Ebenezer Franklinton. I was dressed like this, and I made them put their hand out because that's whimsical.
It was very whimsical.
Very whimsical.
Then I had some of my friends, some of the top writers in Nashville, and a special guest artist, Jordan St. Cyr, joined us, and he played his hit songs. And so that was a lot of fun. A lot of people said that was like one of their favorite parts. We got to show them how I record a podcast interview, and they got to be part of a live audience of the Matthew West podcast. I did a book signing at the cutest little bookstore downtown Franklin. And that was so much fun. Saturday night was big time. Fancy dinner, turkey, ham.
Green beans.
Roast beast. Yes, green beans, all the things. And our team had it decorated just gorgeous. I mean, you walk in, you're like, it felt like Christmas. And what the crowd maybe didn't realize is that I brought the full band for a big show and a big Christmas show. Everybody wearing suits and ties and the horns were playing. And so we had this dinner and a show. Sunday morning, the idea was we're gonna come together for one last time. We're gonna have donuts and coffee and hot chocolate and really have a worship service too. My dad was the special guest speaker and he brought a powerful message. And of course we played some songs from the new record. What I really wanted to do was give a ton of gifts away, like, because that's whimsical. Most festive.
Who
traveled the furthest distance. Many people came from many miles
away.
I had my mom help me pass the gifts out, so lots of fun. The whole weekend was just really special, and a lot of people, I think one of the most meaningful things was people sharing with me why this weekend was important to them. Of course, there was a couple that got engaged. There was another couple celebrating their 37th anniversary. There were families bringing their little kids.
Yes, there was a woman who brought her 15-year-old daughter, and she said this is all she wanted for Christmas.
And they like surprising their family members, and they were on a road trip, but they didn't know where they were going. So just like, that's whimsical, right? So it was really special for one weekend in Franklin, Tennessee. The stories of a whole bunch of people's lives got to intertwine and intersect and connect. And I believe we've made some really special memories at Come Home for Christmas. So perhaps we should do this again sometime.
Maybe next year.
Maybe.